is Malika from Ideas Modular Kitchens and Interiors Rajouri Garden. Today, as promised, we would be discussing the kitchen in the movie Piku. This is a slightly more traditional kitchen. In today's day and age, we call it the Shaker series. It basically means that it has very warm colors and is made of hardwood. So without any further delay, let's get right into the movie clip. So in the beginning of the clip, you can see that it is basically a very nice Shaker series kitchen. Shaker series basically means that it has warm colors, which are basically orange. And I'm guessing that this was actually a hardwood kitchen, including the shutters as well as the boxes. And you can see it's a semi-open kitchen. You can see a lot of the kitchen from the outside, but the kitchen is not part of the living room. You can see that there is an open box on the base where you've got books and everything, which again is an attempt to make it a part of the living space as well. And a lot of the shutters are basically open shutters, open shelves, and the shutters basically have glass on it. The good thing about this is that it you can see everything that is inside the shutters, thus you don't have to open up a lot of cupboards to access what you're looking for, so as you can see. But this disadvantage is that you need to make sure that everything is kept in an organized way so that it doesn't look untidy. And another disadvantage of the open shelves especially is that it is more susceptible to dust and pests and flies and everything, so sometimes it is necessary that before you use any cup or plate that you pick up from it, that you need to rinse it before you use it. You can see in the video that the microwave is basically kept on the shelf, which is blocking some of the space that could have actually been used for chopping, etc. So that is, I think, one slight disadvantage that I can see in this. Another thing that I would like to point out is that they have black countertops, and I think if you would just replace the black countertops with a lighter countertop, it would completely elevate the look of the kitchen, and that would also match the tiles really well. Oh, and in this, I missed out before, but tried to make this part of the kitchen into something that can be used, while you're serving it as well. Since you can see that there are drawers as well as cabinetry that can be accessed from the outside instead of the inside. Open shelves, and again, that they've used the loft, they've not covered up the loft, because they would know that, that would completely block out that space and give the entire room in this case, which is because it's an open kitchen, a very heavy look. And as you would notice in this entire video, that the cooking is basically on the right hand side wall, which is not visible from outside. So I think that is a very smart decision that was taken by whoever made this kitchen. But as you can see, this is still a relatively crowded kitchen, because a lot of the plates and the regularly used plates are kept on the dish rack that is basically on the counter. And I think they could have easily given a cabinetry for that, and put the dish rack accessory in it, so that the plates that are used regularly could have been kept over there and not occupied so much counter space. I think to wrap it up, the basic advantages and things that you can take away from the Piku kitchen is that it was a semi-open kitchen, which means that they had made provisions like the open boxes and the drawers as well as the shutters being opened from the side from where people were dining rather than from the inside of the kitchen. So that made the entire kitchen a part of the living area as well. The second takeaway that the advantage that was there was that they were using the space above the wall shelves, but they had not covered it up, which means that they had not used a loft, and that was the reason why their kitchen did not have a very heavy look. The disadvantages of it was that the countertop was of a very dark color, because of which it gave the entire kitchen a slightly more old look, but it was quite an old kitchen, so that can't be helped. The second disadvantage was that they had open shelves and glass shelves. So in the glass shelves, they had to make sure that they had to keep everything in a very organized manner. The disadvantage of the open shelves is of course the dust, and that it's more susceptible to flies, etc. So every time they would have to use those cups or plates, they would have to wash them. The third disadvantage was that instead of having the dish rack inside a cupboard, they basically had it right beside the sink, which basically means that while it's drying, it's also getting dirty because it's out in the open, and that's not very hygienic. And also that because they did not have a provision for a roller shutter or a different wall box, a lot of their counter space was getting eaten up by the microwave. Another advantage which I forgot to mention was that the living space was on the right wall, which basically means that you could not see it from the living area, which was actually great because that is the space where a lot of messy job happens, but you're not able to see it from the outside. So yeah, I think overall it was a pretty solid kitchen. It was a good size, and from what we could see, it was well organized and well used. Thank you for watching the video. We hoped you liked it and you found that it was useful. The next movie that we would be doing, whose kitchen that we really like, is Chef, the one in which Saif Ali Khan stars. And please leave us in the comments if there is a kitchen that you spotted in a movie that you would like us to use. Share this video and other videos that we've made on our channel with people who are making their house and you think need help in their interiors. And for any more information, please leave us your questions in the comments. Thank you, and we'll see you next time.